Hello everybody, and welcome once again to another English session, English 1. Remember that this course is part of the online program Vamos para la Universidad, led by Universidad de Antioquia. I send always special greetings to all teachers and students who are participating in this program. And you know that what we want you to do is improve your English level in your institutions. Today, in this session, that is a very important one that corresponds to week four, class two of the unit one. We are finishing the unit one, all right? And this is important because we are like making a compilation of what we studied in the whole unit. And you today, you have a special assignment because you are going to demonstrate how much you have learned so far, okay? So this is really a really important class. Remember that in the previous session, we mentioned the objectives of this week, which are that we had the capacity to talk about our routines, yes, our habits, everyday activities, that we have the capacity to make a contrast between these activities and the ones that we are doing at the moment of speaking. And finally, to demonstrate all the knowledge that we have learned, that we have acquired so far and in the whole unit. Yes, doing an actividad de creación. Okay, that's what we are going to do today. Okay, so let's start with the first introductory activity. All right, we are going to observe a picture that you have there. Well, there are various pictures, yes, of people and objects. What I want you to do in your classrooms is that check what occupations do you see in the pictures. Okay, what occupations do you see? And we are going to mention about what are the normal activities that you do in these occupations. Okay, so you two students in the class, yes, talk about this. Again, I repeat, what occupations do you see in the picture? Yes, and what activities do people normally do under these occupations? Are the instructions clear? Tell me if the instructions are clear for the exercise, for the initial exercise. All right. Okay, now you begin. Yes, I see a secretary, very good. I see a photographer, that's right. Who else do you see? A teacher, all right. A decorator, all right. Who else do you see? So secretary, teacher, decorator, photographer, a student. All right. Well, probably associated with the homework. Yes, why not? What else? All right, I'm gonna make the list here, the list of the occupations that you mentioned. All right, so we have a secretary, all right, a teacher, you say, a photographer, a decorator, okay. Who else do you see? I think that I'm gonna use this board better because it's with bigger letters. Tell me about some actions, some activities that a secretary does every day. All right, very good. Type letters. Any other activity that a secretary does every day? All right. She organizes. I'm gonna put here, organizes files or documents. Very good. What else? Answers the phone. Any other activity that a secretary does? Very good. Helps her boss very good. Now let's see a teacher. What does a teacher normally do? Well, okay, teaches, yes. That's logical. Teaches, let's complement. Teaches various subjects. Okay, like for example, English, mathematics, geography, history. Checks the homework. All right. Checks the homework. And assigns the homework as well. Okay, what else? Writes on the board. Okay. What other activities does the teacher do? More activities that a teacher does in his or her everyday life. Explains, very good. Explains topics. What else? Okay, checks the exams. That's another good option. All right. Now let's say a decorator. What does a decorator do? Paints doors. Or, well, houses. What else? He paints houses. Organizes rooms, okay. That's a good one. Design places, very good, Marco Emilio. Design places. What else? What other activities does a decorator do? A decorator cleans, what do you think? Agricola de Tamesis. Yes, a decorator cleans places. Or what do you mean by the decorator cleans? Okay, very good, Lorenzo Yali. Maybe organizes parties and events. Probably, yes. Any other option? Yes, parties, very good. Now you mention, you also mention a student. What does a student normally do? Okay, the student does homework. Very good. Learns lessons. Okay, learns about topics, different topics. Yes. This is a very good one. Agricola de Tamis, it wakes up early to study. That's a good one. Plays as well. Again, that's a very good one. Learns lessons. Yes. Institución Procesa Delgado. Very good. Learns lessons. Learns about different topics. Yes. Yes. They learn about many things. Many subjects. About mathematics, geography, history, sciences. Aha. That's a good one. Agricola de Tamesis. Bothers the teachers. Yes, they bother the teachers. That's a good one. All right. This is like a very good introduction for the activity that you have in the... in your platform, okay, on your platform, in the virtual course. So please, before we do the exercise, that is very simple, we are going to check the meaning of these actions. All right, you know the meaning of answer. Okay, Marco Emilio, responder. Okay, contestar, very good. Okay, write on. What's the meaning of write on? Escribir sobre algo, very good. Lorenzo Yalí, Marco Emilio, very good. Now, water. No, look at the question. Actions, we are talking about actions. Agua is not an action. Very good. Institución Educativa El Salto y Marco Emilio. It could be regar o mojar. Yes, possible. Okay, regar. All right, now type. What is this action? Type. Digitar, very good. Digitar, that's a good one, Marco Emilio, very good. Cut, cortar, very good, cortar. Now this one, mark. What is mark? Marcar, okay, it could be, it could be. Another option for mark. Wait, hold it. Estamos en mark. What, give me another meaning for mark. Señalar, puede ser, bien. Les voy a poner aquí, mark. In this context, is a synonym of grade. Mark is normally used by British, and grade is normally used by Americans. What would be the meaning? ¿Cuál será el significado? Mark or grade. Very good, Lorenzo Yalí. Very good. Calificar. Very good. Calificar. That's a good one. Okay. Now, give. Dar. Muy bien. Take. Tomar. That's a good one. Paint. Pintar. Decorate. Decorar. Serve. Servir. Very good. And finally, use. Usar o utilizar. Very good. Now you are going to on your platform. Yes, and in the virtual course, I'm going to share the screen with you in this moment. Give me a couple of seconds. All right. I'm going to share with you the activity that we are going to do. Remember that we are in week 4. Yes. And you are going to click in this activity. What do they do every day? It's under the title of Actividad de Comprensión, all right? The second one, la segunda, porque las dos se llaman igual. Se llama Actividad de Comprensión, What do they do every day? Pero la segunda, la que tiene el icono de cuestionario, all right? You open it and you are going to find the exercise that I was showing to you. You have here the picture. Pay attention in this part here. You have the pieces of text that you need to complete a text, and you have here the pictures. Okay, the idea is that you complete these sentences, these ideas, with the information that you have here at the top of the exercise. Is that the instruction clear? I'm going to All right, I'm going to repeat. Go to your virtual course, okay? And then you click on the activity that is called Actividad de Comprensión. What do they do every day? Hasta ahí vamos bien. All right. So you have, you find here in the top of the screen, you find the options to complete the text. Then you have the pictures, all right? And in the bottom, on the bottom, en la parte de abajo, you find the exercise to complete, all right? Do the exercise and then we compare the answers, all right? I'm going to give you like a couple of minutes for that. All right, do the exercise, please. It's very simple. All right. Okay, let's begin checking together. The first idea, Wendy is tell me the answer. Wendy is a secretary, very good. She, what activities does she do? Tell me the answers. Wendy is a secretary. She who has, okay, no, according to the exercise. Remember that we are doing the exercise on your virtual courses on the platform. Estamos con Wendy. Estamos con Wendy todavía. The pictures. Okay, I'm going to. All right. Here you have the pictures. Very good, Lorenzo Yali. I'm going to write the answer here. Wendy is a secretary. She answers. Excuse me. She answers the telephone. And yes, she answers the telephone. What else? ¿Y qué más? She types letters. Very good, Lorenzo Yali. She types letters. That was the answer, okay? Ya tenemos a Wendy. Very good. Now, Diana. Very good, Sajuabel. Diana is a teacher. Diana is a teacher. Okay, what about the activities? She writes on the board. Very good. She writes on the board. And what else? She marks the homework. Very good, Lorenzo Yali. She marks the homework. Well, so far so good. Hasta ahí vamos bien. Ya llevamos a Wendy and Diana o Diana. Let's continue with the other people. Walter. What does Walter do? Shop assistant. Very good. He is a shop assistant. All right. And very good, Lorenzo Yali. He serves customers. He helps clients, very good. Remember that we are doing the exercise on the platform with the options that we have on the platform. He gives change. Very good, Lorenzo Yali. Very good. He gives change. Okay, he gives change. Very good. Now, Eduardo. Is a decorator. Very good. What does he do? He decorates rooms. Excellent. He decorates rooms. And he paints doors. Very good. Excellent. He paints doors. Remember that we are checking the exercise that you have on the platform, all right, in the virtual course. Now, Harold. What does Harold do? He's a gardener. Very good. Excellent. He's a gardener. What does he do? He waters the flowers. Very good. He waters the flowers. And what else? He waters the flowers. And what is the other option? Okay, he cuts the grass. That's great. He cuts the grass. Very good. And finally, Edith. What does she do? Edith. Okay, very good. She's a photographer. All right. Yes, and what activities? She takes photographs, all right. She takes photographs. And very good, Aura Maria Valencia. She uses software. She uses software. Very nice. Excellent. So we have accomplished the first activity. All right. Congratulations. Now we are going on the second activity, that is actividad guiada. Okay. This is very simple. It's also on your platforms. All right, and it's the contrast. Yes, it's an activity to establish the contrast between everyday activities, yes, as a habit, and activities at the moment of speaking. Okay, it's very simple. Go on your platforms again. I'm going to share screen again. Voy a compartir pantalla otra vez. Give me a couple of seconds. Okay. La actividad guiada que se llama What do they do every day and what are they doing at the moment? So you click there. Están las instrucciones, el objetivo, como siempre. And then you are going to find this. Some pictures about Julián and Tatiana. Okay. And you have some actions here, some verbs to complete the text that you have here at the bottom. Okay. It's very simple and very short. All right, you have the pictures that show about what they do every day and one picture about what they are doing at the moment. So what you have to do is to complete the text. I'm going back here. ¿Están las instrucciones claras? Vamos a ver si aquí está. Aquí la podemos ver. Están las imágenes. Yes, the pictures. These pictures that correspond to what they do every day. And this picture that correspond to what they are doing at this moment. Repito, la actividad está bajo este título, actividad guiada. Y se llama, what do they do every day and what are they doing at the moment. Es la que tiene el título más largo, la última de las actividades guiadas. It's okay. Okay. All right. Entran ahí al ejercicio y hay que completar el texto. Les tomará así mucho un minuto, dos. Okay, completen el texto y ya lo revisamos. No problem, I know. It's a very simple exercise. Sí, San José. I'm going to repeat again. Vamos a actividad guiada. Ahí en la plataforma. La actividad se llama What do they do every day and what are they doing at the moment? Y cuando abren la actividad les va a salir esta imagen que está ahí proyectada en este momento. Están las imágenes de Julián y Tatiana. Listo, estamos bien. Aparecen esas imágenes donde ellos están como haciendo unas actividades cotidianas y después aparece una imagen donde están ellos haciendo algo en este momento. All right. Very good. That's nice. Okay. Good. I'm going to read the text and you are going to tell me what words you use to complete the text. Okay. I'm going to begin reading the text. Are you ready? Okay. Dice el texto. Andrés and Tatiana. What is the first word? Are. Very good, Lorenzo Yali. Are. I'm going to write them here. The first option is are. Okay, boyfriends, according to the text there in the platform. They usually tell me the option according to the platform. Speak, very good. They usually speak. Remember, according to the options that we have in the platform, okay? They usually speak by phone twice a day. She Estoy escribiendo las respuestas aquí en el tablerito. She writes, very good, Lorenzo, very good, Lorenzo Yalit. She writes him through Facebook every day. He, very good, Marco Emilio. He goes to visit her every day. On weekends, they, bien, Aura María Valencia, they dance a lot. Now, the next part of the text. But at the moment, they are not dancing. She, very good, Lorenzo Yali, she isn't writing. She isn't writing through Facebook. They, very good, aren't speaking. By phone. Now the question, what? Yes, very good. That's nice. And now complete the question, what? Bien, Gabriel Echavarría, what are they doing? What are they doing? And the answer, they, very good, Lorenzo Yari, they are fighting. They are fighting and they are, very good, Aura María Valencia, they are shouting at each other, okay? Very good. They are shouting. Again, we finished another exercise. Congratulations. Good job. I'm going back here to the... All right. Congratulations. All right, we finished this activity. All right. Very good. Now we are going to move to the next activity. Como les comenté ahorita al principio de la clase, esta es una de las actividades más importantes de actividad de creación. Okay. Vamos a con esta actividad, recuerden que esta es la actividad evaluativa de la unidad. Alright. Aquí es como la compilación de todos los temas que hemos trabajado y los estudiantes van a hacer el ejercicio para demostrar qué tanto han aprendido. ¿De qué se trata? De que pueden, por ejemplo, grabar un video o hacer una presentación de PowerPoint o hacer un audio, ¿cierto? O hacer una exposición ahí en la clase donde incluyan información personal, ¿cierto? Como decir sus nombres, decir la edad, decir su ocupación, decir información de contacto como su número de teléfono, dónde vive, decir su lugar de origen, su cumpleaños, su fecha de nacimiento, ¿cierto? Porque todo eso lo trabajamos en la primera parte, con números, recuerden, los números, los cardinales, los ordinales. Ok. Van a incluir también descripción física, ¿cierto? Algo sencillo de cómo es la apariencia física de cada uno. Luego, Puede, también hay que incluir información sobre la familia, cómo está compuesta su familia. Y finalmente, contar algo de su rutina. Entonces, si ven, el ejercicio propone que hagan una recopilación de todo lo que se ha trabajado en la unidad 1. Hasta ahí estamos bien. La instrucción de lo que van a hacer. Muy bien, ustedes allá los profesores le ponen una fecha de entrega de este ejercicio con sus estudiantes. Sí, para que ellos tengan tiempo de prepararlo, hacerlo, practicarlo. Recuerden que lo pueden hacer en un video o en un audio o una exposición allá frente a la clase, cosas como esas. Cierto. Voy a dar un ejemplo aquí cortico de cómo lo pueden hacer o qué pueden incluir acá. Voy a hablar de mí. Por acá hay unas opciones. For example. Okay, my name is Arlington and my last name is Galeano. I am 42 years old. I was born on January 7th, 1974. I was born here in Medellín, 100% Paisa. Let's say my phone number. I'm going to invent one, okay? My cell phone number is 300-543-8123. I live in Aranjuez. I work at different institutions. I work at Universidad de Antioquia in a virtual program. Okay. Some physical description about me. I am short. I am a little bit overweight. I am dark skinned. I have short black hair and it's curly. I normally wear a crew cut, corte militar, a crew cut. I have brown eyes, dark brown eyes, and they are like almond, like a little bit like Chinese. Okay. Something about my family. Okay. I have one brother and two sisters, and I have many nephews and nieces. I don't, my mother and my father are dead. Okay. That is something about my family, very short, because I have a small family. Now, my routine. Normally, I wake up early in the morning at 6 a.m. I have to work. So, I take a shower, I get dressed, I eat breakfast, and then I leave home. I go to work about 7:30 in the morning. Then I finish classes at midday, 12, okay? Then I go home and I have lunch. Then in the afternoon, I have more classes until 8 p.m., more or less. Then I go home. I normally take the metro or take the Metro Plus, and I go home, I eat dinner, sometimes I watch the news on TV, and I prepare my lessons, I check homeworks, mark homeworks, and I go to sleep late at night, sometimes at 11 p.m. or midnight. Okay. Muy bien. Miren que ese es un pequeño ejemplo de lo que los estudiantes pueden hacer con toda la información que hemos venido explorando en la unidad 1. Sí, ahí les di como un ejemplo de lo que los estudiantes pueden recopilar, hablando de los nombres, las edades, cumpleaños, bueno, etcétera. Información personal, información de contacto, la familia, y algo de la rutina. Ok. En la mochila, en la unidad 1, ustedes van a encontrar unos tips de cómo hacer un video desde el dispositivo, pues desde el celular. ¿Cierto? Lo pueden explorar para que graben bien el video, les quede bien con volumen los que vayan a hacer un video, por ejemplo. Ok. Eso es para que ustedes lo hagan allá. Ahora, voy a explicar lo que nos vamos a quedar haciendo en este momento. Ok. Porque también tenemos una autoevaluación, unos ejercicios de autoevaluación que están en la plataforma. La idea es que los hagamos todos y ahí y nos damos cuenta de qué tanto hemos aprendido en esta unidad. Ok. Voy a compartir pantalla para mostrarles dónde está. Bueno, recuerden que estamos en la unidad 1, semana 4, ¿cierto? Unit 1, week 4. Y abajo, 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 después de que dice actividad de creación, hay otro icono nuevo, que es como una figura humana con un chulito, y está en rojo, y dice autoevaluación. Y está el cuestionario ahí que dice autoevaluación unidad 1. Cuando entran, van a encontrar, pues obviamente, la explicación inicial, lo general, y van a encontrar una serie de ejercicios. Me voy a retroceder aquí porque yo los estaba observando ahora. Previous page. Ya les muestro cómo comienzan los ejercicios. Porque hay varios ejercicios que cada uno tiene que ver con cada tema que trabajamos en las sesiones. Ok. La idea es que ustedes, los profesores, los hagan allá con sus estudiantes y chequeen qué tanto aprendieron y cómo está planteado como ejercicio de. Como cuestionario, entonces ahí inmediatamente les va a ir calificando el sistema. Miren, cuando abren les va a aparecer este primer ejercicio que dice completa el siguiente texto con el pronombre o la forma correcta del verbo to be, luego lee la descripción completa que Susana hace de su familia, ¿cierto? Entonces ahí tienen el texto, por ahí tienen las opciones para responder. Ok, ese es como el primer ejercicio. Y a medida que nos vamos moviendo donde dice Next Page, entonces van a aparecer otros ejercicios. Por ejemplo, el que sigue es sobre la familia. Tenemos un árbol genealógico y nos empiezan a preguntar sobre las relaciones entre ellos. ¿Cierto? Escogiendo la opción correcta. Luego tenemos un ejercicio con números. Mirando cómo se escriben esos números. Luego tenemos un ejercicio con una imagen. ¿Cierto? Con falso verdadero. Ok, para trabajar la parte de acciones en progreso, el presente progresivo. Y luego tenemos un texto para completar con actividades cotidianas. Ahí también tenemos una imagen, ¿cierto? De dos de los personajes del curso ahí jugando fútbol y tienen el texto para completarlo. ¿Ok? Y finalmente por aquí tienen unos, bueno, aquí también tienen unos ejercicios de escucha. sobre unos números de teléfono, ¿cierto? Cada ejercicio tiene ahí el audio puesto, ¿ok? Ustedes escuchan el audio y seleccionan el número correcto del teléfono que están pidiendo ahí. Y finalmente tienen como un horario de alguien, ¿cierto? Mostrando como las actividades que hace esta persona, Steven se llama, y tienen unas preguntas acá para demostrar comprensión del texto, ¿ok? Entonces, hasta ahí, claro. Cuando hagan clic en comprobar, ahí les va a salir si sacaron bueno o sacaron malo, ¿cierto? Sí, cómo les fue en el ejercicio. Entonces nos vamos a quedar ahí. Yo me quedo aquí un momentico con ustedes. La idea es que recuerden, queda para ustedes la actividad de creación, que les den un poco de tiempo a los estudiantes para que lo preparen. Y en este momento nos quedamos con la autoevaluación, con los ejercicios que hay ahí. Por si de pronto les surge alguna duda, pero recuerden que lo tienen ahí en su curso virtual, en la plataforma, está al final de la unidad 1, semana 4. All right. I hope that you have enjoyed this session, that you have learned a lot during the whole unit. Remember that this is a very important session because we made a compilation of everything, and that you are prepared to start the second unit the next week. Okay? Have a nice day and enjoy everything. All right. Goodbye.